sat down with Fox News ahead of the Super Bowl.
I use the word witch hunt. I use the word hoax. I see the hatred. I see the level. They don't care about fairness. They don't care about lying.
He let loose on his rivals and critics.
What they've done is they've really, all the media, I call it the fake news, and it is fake news, so much of it. And a lot of the fake news is they don't want to report the good stuff. They don't want to report that the economy is good.
One of the two Republican senators who rescued Trump from an extended Senate trial by voting against witnesses,
Mr. Alexander,
said today he doesn't approve of the president's behavior.
I think he shouldn't have done it. I think it was wrong. Inappropriate was the way I'd say improper, crossing the line.
But Lamar Alexander doesn't think the president's conduct.
He'll look at this and say, okay, that was a mistake. I shouldn't have done that.
Judging from the Fox News interview, Trump is not quite ready to bury the hatchet.
Pelosi. I think she's a very confused, very nervous woman. I don't think she wanted to do this. I think she really knew what was going to happen, and it's her worst nightmare has happened.
One of the president's closest allies in the Senate signaled he's ready for payback.
Trump slams impeachment.
You should expect us to do this. If we don't do it, we're letting you down. And I guarantee to you, if it were Democrat, if the shoe were on the other foot, Democrats would be eating us alive.
So this is our ninth Super Bowl. Will be nine.
The Senate is expected to take its final vote on it.
Raging waters, take a look at this, unleashed near homes in Granite Falls, Washington. The storm then moving across the country all the way east. Let's get right to senior meteorologist Rob Marciano.
This is a West Coast storm that is going to go coast to coast with some rough weather in store for California tonight. High wind warnings are posted for parts of San Francisco and Southern California into Las Vegas. Could see gusts to 70, 80 miles per hour. And then the snow is getting into Utah and Denver, Colorado. Could see a significant snowfall for a Monday morning commute. And as this proceeds into the plains and the southeast, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, we've got a three-day severe weather threat that could very well include tornadoes. Looking toward the Iowa caucuses tomorrow.
Thank you.
How could we figure this out?